Yeah, you know, Sharad, what is, when I was listening to you, what is very exciting is that you also went through this cycle of, you know, the dot-com bust that happened. And but, you know, we always hear the stories of the companies in the B2C space, right? This story of surviving, and what an incredible, I can't even imagine what 2001, 2002 would have meant for you. How did you get to this 6, 7, 8 stage?
Yeah, so 2001, 2002, what happened was we realized that we had actually turned cash flow positive within 13, 14 months. See, our, I'm a little, you know, unlike some of the other, you know, entrepreneurs that you've met in Bangalore, right? They have a lot of guts. They're willing to spend a lot of money, build large businesses, and knowing that at some time, the volumes of scale will probably turn them profitable. In my case, it was slightly different. First of all, I don't understand B2C. I understand B2B. I'm very happy that they're doing so well because they're all a lot of them are my customers, and the more they grow, the more businesses for us. So I don't understand B2C. I don't have the guts to do, you know, millions of dollars of marketing without, you know, profit. I would not, you know, just don't have that mindset. So my focus was always on bottom line. And within, I think, 15 months, we knew that the business was generating cash, right? So that was one good thing. Of course, there was a period of time in 2001 where a lot of companies stopped paying us, so we had struggle. We went to the extent of where I had to put in some money. I remember now these guys are famous entrepreneurs, right? Avnish, Suvir, and Niren, right? So they were my first. Bazi.com was one of my first key customers. I think two or three key customers. One was India Infoline, Nirmal Jain, who's still a large customer. One was Bazi, which became eBay. We still do a little bit with eBay, but so in their case, you know, when they were evaluating data center players, they wanted to know that we had enough money. I still remember I put in some money in the bank, personal money in the bank, just to make sure that when they ask for my financials, there's enough money in the bank. So we were down. I remember we had reached down to the last 19 or 20 lakhs in the bank account, right? And this is a capital-intensive business. I mean, today, you know, as I said, each data center we invest over $100 million per data center.
Wow.
So we are down to that much, but fortunately for us, you know, we started building services. So we said when a customer comes, he wants to focus on his core business. So why don't we manage his operating system, database, network, security, web servers, and then provide disaster recovery services. So when we put all these services, so we could upsell to existing customers. And that not only increased our margins, but also increased stickiness in the business.
Yeah.
And that's how we survived.